Hey everyone, ready or not, John Marcaselli is here. Hey John.
Hi Nadia, hi everybody.
John is a speaker for the United Astrology Conference, and he has two wonderful lectures to present for us. One of them is entitled Secondary Progressions, Ready or Not. I'm gonna ask John, what does he mean by that?
But before I do, I'd like to introduce John.
John is a full-time astrologer from New York, and he practices in New York and New York City. He's a past chair of NCGR, and he's currently serving as the president of the New York City chapter of NCGR. He is fully certified by NCGR PAA, and he's a nationwide speaker and a writer and just an amazing human being. He is also a certified psychotherapist, so watch out. John, can you give us a teaser for this lecture that you're going to present at UAC on Saturday, May 26th at 4:30 p.m., the one that is entitled Ready or Not? We'll start with that one first.
Well, I'm very much a predictive astrologer. I believe very much in the value of predictive astrology. And I think it's the unique gift that astrology brings to the helping professions. And to make good predictions, accurate predictions, meaningful predictions, we have to use secondary progressions along with transits, eclipses, and whatever other techniques you might feel comfortable with. But those are the three big ones that I use. And when I say that, when I ask in the title, ready or not, my point is that secondary progressions represent what we're ready for, what we are open to, what we will allow to happen in our lives during a given time. What might happen might be described by the transits, but what we're open to and what we're ready for are the secondary progressions, and they work very much together. So that's where I come up with the title.
Oh, interesting, interesting. So ready or not, I never thought of it in that particular angle about secondary progressions. So I'm really looking forward to get your angle and try to apply in my practice. Another lecture that you have that is very typical of John Marcaselli, whoever knows him, and it's very much all about Saturn. It's on Monday, May 28th, 2:30 p.m., and it's called The Survivor's Guide to Saturn's Journey Around the Horoscope, Part 2. I wonder what happened to Part 1, but find out. So I do want to survive Saturn's journey around the horoscope. I have so far, but the Saturn is coming into Capricorn, so that's a big one. So John, can you give us a little teaser for this one?
First, I'll say that part one took place on the previous UAC. And what that was Saturn moving through the 12 houses, transiting through the 12 houses, and how he brings us through the seasons of our lives is what I'd like to say about it. Saturn is just the manifestation of potential. And if something has the potential to be, to happen, whether we're talking about events or whether we're talking about the creating of something or making something happen, if there's the potential there in the natal chart, then Saturn comes along and makes it happen. And if there's not the potential there, then Saturn will say, that's not the potential. The potential is this other thing over there. So we're going to do part two with this UAC. And part two will be Saturn transiting to the planets. And it will have to the natal planets. And it will have a lot to do with the different kinds of transiting aspects. How is the conjunction different than the sextile, the opening sextile, from the opening square to the opening trine? How is it different from the opposition, the closing trine, the closing square, the closing sextile, and then the conjunction again? And how we can talk about all of those aspects cyclically, all coming out of the conjunction, and also, the older that you get, all repeating. we can always refer back to some earlier version of Saturn in order to learn, in order to, I'll say, correct mistakes, repeat successes, to free ourselves from the past by knowing the past. That's what Saturn helps us to do.
Wonderful. You just mentioned the word success, and usually people don't associate Saturn with success. Usually success is from Jupiter, but I have myself experienced success with Saturn a little bit. So do you believe in Saturnian success?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. It's the manifestation of potential. So if the potential is there for success, for whatever we might be talking about in terms of the planets, the signs, the houses, yes, Saturn makes it happen. Sure.
And what do you think is the difference between Saturnian success and Jupiterianian success?
Jupiter is a free lunch.
Yes, I remember you mentioned that last time you spoke for us about the Jupiter being free lunch.
Saturn is something that is lasting. I don't want to downplay Jupiter. We certainly need Jupiter. I'm very grateful for Jupiter. But I don't associate Jupiter so much with success, really. I think the best of what Jupiter has to offer us is the inspiration and the confidence to do what is ordinarily difficult and dreaded to do. Things that ordinarily, I just don't want to do it. I just can't stand doing it with whatever it might be, whether it's painting your living room or whether it's visiting your mother at Christmas, whatever it might be. But Jupiter comes along and says, "Oh, go ahead. It's not so bad. You can do it. You survived the last time." And Jupiter raises our confidence, gives us the inspiration, gives us a vision, shows us a way, gives us a bright idea on how to get it done. And you know what? It's usually as bad as we remember it being, but it at least gets done.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Let me ask you about the part one. For those who didn't make it to the last UAC and who have no idea what the part one is and might be curious about it, is there any way that people can find it somewhere? Where are the recordings of the part one?
Oh, sure. The recordings from UAC lectures, if I remember correctly, although my memory should never be trusted, but they're on sale on the UAC website.
All right, so folks, if you are curious about the part one and maybe you should prep yourself for the part two,
go to uacastrology.com website, click recordings, and find John Marcasella's lecture
about the survival guide for Saturn, part one. I'm going to probably do that myself because I want to be prepared for that lecture, for the part two. That's great. That's great, John. So thank you so much. This is wonderful. I'm looking forward to getting some more of John Marcasella's Saturn. And also, ready or not, I'm ready for whatever you have to bring at UAC. And everyone, if you want to see John's wonderful new lecture, the part two, and you want to come to UAC and meet him in person and ask him in person what he means by certain things that he says, then please go to the uacastrology.com and register and join a big, exciting crowd of astrologers. It's the event of the century that you don't want to miss. So, John, thank you so much again, and I'll see you at UAC.
See everybody at UAC.